So many people struggle with how to start a presentation with a bang so you captivate your audience's attention. That, my friends, is what we're going to be covering in today's video. How to start a presentation with a bang so you captivate your audience's attention. Hey, it's Tom Jacobs. Thank you so much for stopping by the channel today, because we are all about making those presentations into performances so that you get more profits in your business. And we do that primarily through sales processes for the solo practitioner and the solopreneur. If you're new here, you may want to go ahead and hit that little subscribe button right there. That way you get notified every time new content is created. Now, somebody had posted in one of the comments on one of my videos that I should wear a hat. Or maybe they said I shouldn't wear a hat, or that speakers don't wear hats like this. Well, I don't know. You tell me. Make some comments down below if you like the hat or not, and we'll decide if we want to keep it or not. I kind of like it. It's kind of growing on me. I'm not a hat person. I'm hoping that it's grabbing your attention right now, because that's what this video is all about, is grabbing attention so that you keep your audience's attention for the long term. Now, I want to tell you a little story today about a client of mine who is struggling with her presentations. And we'll just call her Joan for the purpose of this story. Joan was a typical entrepreneur. She loved sales and she loved giving presentations to promote her program, which was basically sending out greeting cards to prospects and clients as a way of growing other people's businesses. She would have the system that sent it all out automatically for them, which is great, because think about this. When you get a card in the mail, you're more likely to open that than if it's just a regular number 10 envelope. So brilliant marketing, by the way. And if you don't do that already, I'm going to put a link down below to a company called Send Out Cards. If you sign up for the system, I do get a commission, and I hope that you do sign up for it. Here's Joan on stage in front of 100 real estate agents. And she looks out in the crowd, and a lot of them are on their phone, or they're just kind of drifting off into space, not really paying attention to what she's saying. And she goes through her 30-minute presentation, and at the end of it, a couple people come up and they sign up for the system. But she's feeling like there's something more, that she's missing something, that there isn't that connection with her audience that she really, really wants. She comes to me and asks for some advice and for some help, and so we go through my full coaching program with her. One of the first questions that I asked her was like, well, why? Why do you have this service in the first place? And why should I care as an audience member to sign up for that service? Because it sounds great, I mean, in theory, but if you're not creating a connection with your audience, then most likely that audience doesn't know why you're trying to sell the service to them and why they should ultimately care. So once we established why they should care, now we needed to figure out kind of a story behind why Joan cared about it and why she started in this business in the first place. And she came up with the normal, oh, I want to help change people's lives, help them with their business, which is all really great. But ultimately I was like, well, but why are you passionate about this? What got you involved in it? And she just kind of stared at me and she's like, well, it's not a story that I particularly want to share with people. I was like, but you have to. Like, why would you not want to share the reason why you got involved in this business and why you want them to get involved in it as well and help them build their own businesses? She said, well, it's really a very sad story, and one that I, you know, am still struggling with today, and I'm not sure if it's something that I really want to share. Really what was happening here is that she was afraid to tell her own personal story. And I find this quite a bit, actually, with a lot of speakers that I work with and salespeople that I work with. It's like, well, why should I share my personal story with people anyway, and especially in a sales presentation or on stage or a webinar, when they don't really know me? I was like, well, that's exactly why, because they don't know you. They need to understand who you are and why you do what you do so that they can root for you and ultimately buy from you because they know, like, and trust you. And that power of the personal story is so important in telling people why you are doing what you're doing. That's why I push people to tell their own personal story, because that's the best story to engage with your audience. whether that's one person or 100 people or even 1,000 people at a time. The power of your personal story is so very potent. Oh, that rhymes. Powerful, potent story. Oh, no, the story doesn't work. Anyway, you get the idea. It's a powerful element in your presentation. And once you create that performance around it, now you have an awesome tool to be able to captivate your audience from the very beginning so that they ultimately take action at the end. And so I worked with Joan on this story. It was amazing the transformation that she went through, because the next presentation that she did, she had double the number of people signing up and a line of people waiting to talk to her at the end of her presentation. And she got more speaking opportunities out of it as well. All of this was possible by her working through the fear of telling her personal story. And now you're probably wondering, she's like, well, what's this personal story that was so powerful? Well, it's her personal story. And it could be your personal story as well. But you always want to start your presentation with a bang with this personal story. And for her, it was a very hard time in her life where her mother and her husband died tragically a day apart from each other. And it was through the power of people sending cards, condolence cards in the mail to her, and businesses sending condolence cards to her, that she realized that people were taking the time to really care. And the cards, and she would feel the cards, she would look at the cards, the inscriptions, and it dawned on her that this was a very powerful way of keeping in touch with people that is almost a lost art. And that was the power of her why, and why she wanted to help these real estate agents increase their business. And when she started her presentation with that very simple story, my mother and my husband died 2 days apart from each other. I mean, everybody's phone went down on the ground. They were with her, eyes on her, for the next 45 minutes of her presentation. And she had a line of people waiting to talk to her, many of them in tears, just as she was as well, to share their personal stories with them as well. But ultimately, she gained the trust because people understood why she was so passionate about sending cards to clients and prospects. Now she will never go back to doing boring presentations where she was just go through the motions of how to set up accounts, how to send out cards and all that, which is just fine. And there's a place for that. But when she started her presentation with a bang, she captivated her audience from the very beginning. And the results were, quite frankly, amazing. And you can do the very same thing. Is when you develop your own personal story, and I've put together a little workbook that you can have. Just click the link down below. It's how to create your own personal story. And once you've created that personal story, now you have a very powerful way of starting a presentation the next time you give a presentation. And I would love to learn how it all worked out for you. So if you have a moment, go ahead and just make a comment down below. Let me know how these all worked out for you. Always curious to know. I also put another video together for you that I think you might enjoy. So you can just go ahead and click on that right there. And until next time, you have a great day. I don't know. What do you think about the hat? Hat stay, hat go, hat stay, hat go. It's up to you. You tell me. Make more comments down below. See you next time. Peace out.